your side on the attack thus far in the game, where Julia Mineta and Allie Gibbons operate.
Good pass Gibbons. From Mineta.
Mineta finds Bell McMahon right in front.
Good team goal from the four. That is magisterial there, Mike.
Magisterial. Absolutely. As Bell McMahon finishes right in front on the feed from Julia Mineta. Another assist for the
team. Yeah, notch another assist for her.
The career assist leader in Haverford College Women's Lacrosse history in just her third year in the program.
Things are looking bright for the forwards, Mike. And inside, Courtney works to her right.
She draws three defenders. Find Kelly Moore.
Callie Crawford's going to look to go inside.
And the finish.
Wow, Mike. Wow.
Well
that is a
from Callie Crawford.
Great goal from Callie Crawford. Coming in big off the bench. That's what the forwards need. You know, they need a good bench presence here today. Super sub. Yeah. It's a great goal. Moving over there to Haley Morris. Haley Morris works to Allie Gibbons. Allie Gibbons rolls to her right. Looks for a cutting pass, but cannot find one. Mineta's looking now. Finds a good one to Maeve Gaffney, who slots that one home for the forwards. Another good team goal. Julia Mineta is looking for a penetrating pass with a dissecting vision. She does find Pascarella. Works back to her right. Takes contact. That is magisterial, Mike. I got to clap for that one in the booth. Pascarella took the contact and dished a beautiful pass to Allie Gibbons, who slots it home for her second of the day. The forwards are...
Got a look on goal, and she finishes.
Great.
That's her third of the
finesse
day.
Finesse slot there.
She's the leading goal scorer in Centennial Conference for a reason. She got a nose for the goal, and she's not going to miss from there.
Showed a great two-way player there, Allie Gibbons, as she picked up that ball on the far side of the field and oh so calmly slotted it into the bottom side of the net to open the side of the field for them, and that will probably do it
and
for us today in this contest.
Solid Centennial Conference opening victory for these forwards, the number 23 team in the country. Proving why they're number 23. And going into the matchup with FNM on Wednesday with some confidence.
This is an upset team, Mike, so they could come back with big upset.
They already have one of the biggest upsets in D3 women's lacrosse this year. Can they pull off another one on Wednesday? Hopefully they have enough confidence after this win today.